This is RLGVH10, Neptune. Today's topic is called tree. Our example is UART. Sometimes people call this SealBot. And the last step, we will study the register about the UART. The lab manual is long, so please go through the lab manual before start the experiments. This lab, we will use a two UART board. The UART one be used in lab one for download. Then another UART two we will use today. UART two, please check the jumper. The RX PA three connect to RXD and PA two connect to TXD. Let's know what's the UART or serial port. Now, actually the CPU use serial port. On the board, you can find the chip CH340. This is USB to serial converter, so you can use the serial USB cable connect the PC to the board. And another port, this UART2 connector is the type is the DB line. Actually, the CPU connect to DB line serial port directly. So you have to use another kind of the cable. One side USB, another side is DB line connect to the board. Actually, in this cable body, you the USB to serial converter inside. And you can find a lot of the standard. For example, RS-232, RS-485, and RS-222 or 422 or 423. The protocol. Their protocol are the same, but the electrical signal, some is voltage, some you can't current, some you can't differential in or single end input. So the engineer form a different kind of the spec. Now our board, the PA line PA10 through the onboard 6340, then convert to USB, then you can use the USB cable to download. And another side, PA2 and PA3 connect to the DB line socket. This socket is DB line. Then you have to use a cable within a USB to serial converter inside. This is board diagram. Then the physical pin RXTX. Then connect to the inside register. The inside is TX and RX, or both call a data register. In the program, when you call the serial port data register, if you send data, means the call using a transmit data register. When you do the receiving, that means that data register point to the receive data register. And this CPU is an advanced model, so it has two level register for the serial port. One is data register and another is a shift register. But two levels is enough, so more level cannot get the advantage. Now, what is UART or RS-232? RS-232 is for communications. I think it has developed more than 50 or 60 years. We'll call this a serial communication. For serial communication, one is the DTE. DTE today we'll call this, for example, computer. Then when you do communication, you have to use another device, DCE. Data communication equipment or data circuit terminal equipment. Many years ago, this is a modem, telephone modem. So you have to do DTE, the TX, connect to DCE, RX. Okay, then DCE, TX will connect to DTE, RX. Then telephone line connect to another PC. How how to present the capabilities of this on the line, then we'll use this line 1600 AN1. What does it mean? Line 1600 is the BPS, the bit rate. Okay, means that 1 second will transfer our 10,000 bit. And 8N1 means the A data bit, long parity bit, and one stop bit. 9600 BPS one bit is 100 microseconds. Normally, RS-232 or serial port, we will use line pin RS-232C, or call this is DB line socket. Okay. Today we only use the data pin, TX, RX, and ground pin, and other pins for serial control. Of course, today nobody will use telephone modem, so normally we'll use a serial port connect to another PC directly or connect to another device. So when you connect to both DTE, then you have to use a low modem. Low modem is not a modem. Low modem is a wire connection or a cable. Mainly is the TX connect to another side RX like this. Okay, this low modem. And important is ground, this reference port. So other control signal then will feedback to yourself. This controls everything. Okay. Okay. Let us what's AN1? AN1 is A data bit, and non-parity bit, parity bit here, and one stop bit here. In CPU, if your CPU is 5 volt, then we will use a 0 volt, means the logic 0, and 5 volt logic 1 or high voltage. But in our 232 standard, it will use the positive and negative voltage. The positive voltage we will call space. The negative voltage we will call mark. If you send data continuously, then stop it, data bit, stop it, stop it, data bit, stop it, like this. Then if one bit is missing, what's happened? Then means that everything will shift. Okay, now what is the one level and two level register? Our STM32 is a two level. Now in old model, the transmit data register or shift register, data register and shift register together, then this one level. Then this our model STM32 will separate the data register and shift register. Now what different? Yeah, come back here. Every bit, actually this register will change, but the two level, that means that when the data come, only the register, a shift register will change every bit. And when come here, and when the whole shift register complete, will copy to the data register, means the data register will be changed when the 8 byte complete. So if one register, then your process time have only one bit. If the two level register, means that your process time is the byte. So more than two level will better, then I will say no, because the process time are the same, two level or three level. Okay, then now let's start know the clock tree. This is clock tree in our CPU, this part. We will use HSE, external crystal, connect to here. and use a phase not loop and multiply the frequency, then we'll generate the system clock. The system clock distributes 72 MHz. Then we will downgrade the system clock for low speed device and high speed device. For high speed device, you can keep the maximum is the 72 MHz. For low speed device, then the maximum is 36 MHz. Remember, we have the system clock 72 MHz maximum, and we will have two APB1 and APB2 for low speed device and high speed device. Now, in our experiment, one method is that we describe the task, then student compose the program. I think this is no good, right? So we will use another trend. Then we will give you some example, but you have to study the example and what the given program did. Then try to read the data sheet, understand the program, understand how they work. Then based on the knowledge, then you can duplicate and modify our given program, then do the similar task. Now, so experiment 2.1 and 2.2 set up the clock. So we give you the program. You need the clock. Then please read the data sheet, understand what the program does. Actually, the path like this. Okay, then in here, we'll use alternate function. In experiment 1, we study the output and input. So experiment 2, we'll use alternate function. Then we'll use the alternate functions. UART1 is PALI PA10, UART2 is PA2 and PA3. Now, when you use alternate function, the signal come from outside to here, then through the Smith trigger. So after that, must be high or low. Then use alternate function this path. So you will not use the input data register. You will use another register for alternate function. Now start the 9600 and AN1. If the clock is 36 mega, then we'll divide by 16, D40, and this is bit by. So you have get two number. One is Mantissa, and another is a fashion. Because the clock is divided by 16, so you get the number 6. This is a formula from the datasheet. Then you need the UART port, then you have to set the clock 36 mega and the bit rate 9600. So with the line menu, what the program does. You change to UART 1, then set the clock to 9600 and use the high speed clock 72 MHz. Okay, the tools we'll use. The tools EagleCom, this communication program. Then when you turn on this, you have to set the bit rate 9600 AN1 and set the port. Okay, maybe COM3 or COM4. Then this is enable the port. When you send the data, this program will give you the send the data. DRL, data register. Now DRL data register equals something. Means that you put some into data register. This is for TX purpose. when you read something, when you read something from data register, means that you are talking about the data register for receiving. Now the transmit and receive are separated, although they use data register, DR. And how to send out a string, explain 2.3. Then send the string. When you want to send the string 12345, actually 5 character, actually we will send 6 register. The last one is 0. 0 is normally this is null. So means that end of the string. Okay, then check the DX bit. Now the stated register, then here are some bits for TXE. Okay, means that when this bit empty, when the data register empty, then the, this bit will set. So check this register TXE, then you can know the transmit is complete or not. If complete, you can send another character. Then how to read? Then of course you can use a polling method with the RX register, but this is not good. So actually process receiving, then you have to use interrupt. Interrupt is the left 4. Okay. Then at this time you can know what the advantage of the 2-level register. Now the question, if one bit, another question is one bit missing, then means that this bit everything will shift one bit. Then you are software programmer, then you think how to solve the problem. Okay, thank you very much.